Right, okay, guys. So, I was recently asked if I'd be interested in reviewing Five Nights at Freddy's Into the Pit, which is one of their new games that's come out. And it was someone from Mega Cat Studios saying to me that if I wanted to review it, they could give me a Steam key for it. So, as a result, I said yes, because I thought, well, I've never played one of these games before. Sounds quite interesting, so I'll give it a bash. So, I'm basically going into this game completely blind. I've never played one of these before. So, basically, I haven't got my mind made up either way. It's going to be totally unbiased because I've never played one of these before. The other thing is, there was no pressure for me to actually do a video on this. I was literally just asked to review the game. So, I thought, well, why not do a video as well? Because actually, I quite enjoyed it. But anyway, let's talk and let's take a look at the gameplay. And then at the end, I'll give you my thoughts on it.
Oh, Thank you.
Right, okay guys, final thoughts. So, number one, this game I really enjoyed, and I'm not just saying that, I honestly did. It's perfect for me. As you know guys, if you watch the channel, my channel's all about retro. One of my favourite eras of gaming is 16-bit. This game looks 16-bit, right? It's got that retro pixelated look to it, like we're seeing with a lot of the new Switch games, and obviously the company's Mega Cat Studios. We've seen several of their games that look like this. For example, Coffee Crisis, which is another game I've covered on this channel. And I enjoyed that. And I'd say this game's no different. As you know, I enjoy point-and-click adventures. If you've watched the channel long enough, you'll know that one of my fan favourites back in the day was Beneath a Steel Sky. So when I was asked to have a look at this, I thought, yeah, why not? I've never played it. I'm going into it unbiased. I'll give an honest review of this. And I should add, I wasn't told I had to do a video on this. I was just asked to review it, have a look, play it, see what I thought. But I thought I'd do a video because I really enjoyed this game. And I want to tell everybody about it because if you're into your point-and-click adventures and if you like your retro-style games, you should be playing this. It is fun. Now, you'll notice when you're watching the game, I ended it a little bit sooner than I'm supposed to. As you could see, I left the building, so it ended it there. I didn't want to show you everything because If I do, what's the point in you guys playing it? I would have given it all away. So next time I go back, and there will be a next time, because, you know, half hour went pretty quick playing this, I've got to say. I'll go back and obviously I'll go and look for the two guys that I just met. So there's always going to be that extra added bit that I've not seen before. And I guess this is probably going to happen several times going through this game, because you can always make a wrong turn in these games and it ends quicker than it should do for you, which means that you then go back and you do it again, right? That's the whole point. So yeah, I really enjoyed this game. I like this style of game, this retro style. I definitely like point and click. And so for me, it was perfect. And I'd say anyone who's into their retro 16-bit style games would definitely enjoy this also. So yeah, I really did like this. I think for me, if I was to give it a rating out of 10, I'd give this a solid 8. I really enjoyed it and I will carry on playing it. Anyway, that's all there is for this video, guys. I hope you've enjoyed the video. And until next time, take care, stay safe. Nerdy Geezer out.